Hi, everybody. How are we doing?
Good.
My name is Hugh McLeod. I'm a cartoonist and I'm a blogger. And I love cartooning. I love blogs. I get really cynical about marketing because I've been in it for so long. This one says, why is your head up your ass? This guy's going, my head is not up my ass. My head is living the brand. Which anybody who's ever been in marketing long enough will get that. I had this insight that, or had this idea that you could really kind of focus on why you're doing it as opposed to what you're selling, then your marketing message or your marketing strategy gets a lot more interesting real fast. So an idea of not just belief as an important thing to do personally, but also as a way of getting a lot of making your company and product and marketing a lot better. I got a call from a small winery in South Africa called Stormhook. And they really like social media, and they kind of asked me to get involved, a guy called Jason Corman. I did this t-shirt about a year ago for a friend of mine who works for Doyle Dane Burnback, the large Chicago advertising agency. And they were doing a pitch. And I just, you know, that was kind of like, we are not in the advertising business. We are in the decommodification business. Because, you know, big agencies, they sell a lot of fast-moving consumer goods. You know, they do a lot of toilet paper, soap, suds, cornflakes, that kind of thing. You know, so they're all commodities, and I guess their value comes from helping by creating all these memorable campaigns to decommodify what are commodities. So I was kind of thinking to myself, you know what, wine's a commodity, so maybe we're not really, maybe the action isn't so much in the grapes. You can always hire somebody to grow grapes. You know, the mojo is in the decommodification of wine, and made especially harder if you're very small, don't have a marketing budget. And then the other thing we started doing is in America soon after is we started sponsoring geek dinners, because you know, all these bloggers like to kind of meet up and have geek dinners. So what we did is print out that print, Buy Me or the Puppy Gets It, and I signed 1,000 of them, and they started having geek dinners, and we started sending wine to them, saying, you know, if you guys are having a geek dinner, let me know, I'll send you some stuff. And so what we'd do is we'd send some wine to the parties, and we'd send some prints, and not so much trying to get a message to them, like, here's why you should buy our wine, why don't you go blog it and tell all your friends. It was more like, it was a social gesture, really. It's just saying, well, I think you're kind of cool. Here you go. This is what we do. You know, rock on. We're now like the cult Silicon Valley wine, even though Napa Valley is only 30 miles away from them. You know, we're thousands of miles away from them. And the reason we got there is because we made a social gesture. Hey, we like you. We think you're neat. And we know what you're doing. We're not just trying to buy you. And that was reciprocated. It's not the object that's interesting. It's the conversations that gravitate around the objects that are interesting. Two friends of mine, Stuart Butterfield, who founded a company called Flickr. Anybody heard of that? Okay, another friend of mine, Yuri. He's a brilliant young anthropologist. He used to work for Nokia. Well, Yuri was talking about social objects and how that in the web, the companies that really succeed in the Web 2.0 have social objects built into them. For example, Flickr. Is it about the photographs? Is it about storing digital images online? Well, yeah, that's part of it. But what makes Flickr really compelling? What made Yahoo want to spend $40 million buying it was saying, you could share it. Yuri went on to say that social objects have a noun and a verb. For example, with Flickr, the noun is photo, and the verb is share. Let me think of another one. Upload, or find out information, or whatever. But there's a kind of word and there's kind of a noun and verb, and the whole point of these things, the whole point of what makes Twitter or makes Facebook, what makes Facebook really interesting is not that you can, you know, keep all your day-to-day minutiae on a blog or on a kind of meta blog, is that you get to share yourself with so many people, and it makes it so easy to do so. It's all about social objects. And you want to market something, create a social object. Create something people want to share. You know, Apple doesn't have to advertise its phone. his new phone because you want to talk about it. And I've been thinking about Web 2.0 a long time as what does it mean for marketing, what does it mean for PR, what does it mean for advertising. And my belief is, and I've pretty much staked my entire career on the future, or my future career on being right on this, is from now on, if your marketing doesn't have any kind of social object within it, you don't have marketing, you just have junk. So think about what a social object is, try to find your own, try to develop your own, try to make it your own, try to find out about it, because to me, that's the future of marketing. And thanks so much for listening to me.
What you've seen today is that the whole blogosphere and beyond that into other forms of social media is an incredibly complicated and interesting place to be for any communications professional at this point in time, I think. And something that we should all be certainly looking at, whether or not we decide to do anything, I think, as people have said here, it's got to be down to whether or not you actually find a need, whether or not you actually could develop a social object, whether you actually can see some strategic value in doing it in terms of your own engagement with it. I think some of the research we've seen hopefully shows that there's a lot of people out there that are doing it. It's a case of whether or not they've got it right or not, I think, is a case at the minute. Just in terms of what Inferno does in that area, we've sort of tried to modularize some of the approaches that people can take to this whole world of blogging, and obviously some of our other digital services we can talk about afterwards, but I'm not going to spend time going through those. But it is a very complicated thing. We try to sort of just offer some simple services that get people on the right track, that ask the right questions, that start to set up the right mapping and engagement strategies for people,